Okay, I will start with the theme selector that the design is similar to elementary, so GNOME users may not be familiar with that, without meaning it is a bad thing. Then we have a Hemingway option, that we basically can't delete text. Then it's the focus mode. What does, is when we type it starts from the middle of the editor. And notice how the header bar is fading out to give us some less distraction. But distractionless editing goes a step further. When we get on new line, the previous line text gets a less powerful color. If we disable the focus mode, the text will start from the top of the editor. And if we set the light theme, we'll also notice that the text isn't fading anymore. Set to quickly show you the focus mode with the light theme and the font's coloring. From preferences we can disable the header bar auto-hide when we're typing, if for some reason we don't want that. And moreover, we have some different markdown formats to choose from. Another nice thing is that we have a words and letters counter, that it can also calculate the reading time. Okay, let's go to the actual editor. From that menu we can select the view modes, that the most interesting is obviously the half-width. So we type markdown on the left side, and on the right side we get a real-time preview. That alone is nothing impressive, but it gives a good feeling and the performance is relatively okay, even without hardware acceleration. Another thing we can do, is to drag an image from the file manager, and drop it to the markdown editor. Something I do not like though, is that if we right-click on the image we won't get an open with option, so we can quickly edit it with an image application. Next we have the rest view modes that most probably we rarely gonna use. There's the half height, and notice how it changed the window size. Then we have the windowed mode that opens separated windows for the markdown and the previewer. And finally we have this insane bug, and it is not the only UI issue I found. I was used to blame such things, but now developing a GTK application myself made me to realize everything. Writing GTK hasn't any logic. People doing it only because they love GNOME, so I'm gonna skip the complaints, but however the problem remains. Deja vu, I've just been this place before. Higher on the street and I know it's time to go. If we go to keyboard shortcuts, we'll see shortcuts for formatting the text, like making it bold or italic. So if we type something on Markdown Editor, we can select it and quickly format it. By the way, that doesn't play really good, so if we make a multi-line text, and then select it and try to make a list, it will add a list only on the first item. Of course, that's a bug and not my actual wish list. My wish list is for Apostrophe to do something like Medium, that we can type the text and format it on the same view. I don't know how Medium works behind the scenes, but I guess it produces Markdown or something similar. Because when you have two views open and you have to watch both, that's the definition of a non-distraction free editor, as Apostrophe wants to be called. Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shake your souls. I will start with the very biggest issue of this app. If we click on open, we get a recent files list, which is pretty nice and I'm very pissed they removed it from GNOME Text Editor 336. But if we try to create a new file, then Apostrophe will ask us to close the current, which means it can't support multiple open documents, and that's quite terrible for such app. Apostrophe has a search and replace that can also use regular expressions. But the problem here is the theme. You see that yellow? I bet you know how awful and unreadable can get on real searches, and Apostrophe doesn't support editor theming. In fact we can't even change fonts. This app can export literary to anything, and that is a huge plus. However if you want LaTeX support, you will need a 300 MB Flatpak plugin that is only specific to this app. Probably you will never need that, so it is not a big deal, but I'm just mentioning it. Apostrophe isn't exactly loaded, but it is not poor either. However missing themes and the ability to open multiple documents will give it 4 out of 10. Apostrophe launch times are good, and at least on Medium Markdown files performance is okay. But this is really an app all about the UI, and GTK is the slowest toolkit today. So till we get GTK 4, it can't score more than 3 out of 10. This app is above GNOME app's average, and I totally love the vanishing header bars and also the views button slider. But still, GTK can't exactly deliver great visuals, so 5 out of 10. Graphics and features aside, the design is pretty good, as in most of GNOME apps anyway. Everything is exactly where it should be, and it does good what it can do. So 7 out of 10 here, but if it was including my wishlist item that would be easily a 9. Apostrophe is active development but it is not lollipop level. To be honest, I found enough bugs around, and some things like a font selection are desperately missing. So, 4 out of 10. That's kind of the major issue with GNOME apps in general. People want really strong apps and community can hardly deliver in their free time. Especially in this case, most of people will write Markdown inside Visual Studio Code. But Apostrophe has its place nevertheless. For all those with membership at I Hate Chromium Apps fan club. Still, it can't get more than 2 out of 10. So we run GNOME desktop, and we really want to use native GNOME apps. Apostrophe works fine, it looks even better, and it doesn't have bugs that will destroy our peace of mind. Except that view switcher maybe. And besides, I'm not even sure if there is an alternative, so 6 out of 10. Oh, and you should consider 6 a very high number.